Out of respect for the Indigenous people of Manitoba, we at Danny McIntyre and the Winnipeg School Division recognize that the school we attend resides in Treaty 1 land, known as First Nations territory, as well as the homeland of the Métis Nation.
Good morning, graduates, family, friends, and staff. I'm Mrs. Legan, and I'll be your MC for today. On behalf of the DMCI admin team, grad committee, and staff, we would like to welcome you to this year's virtual grad ceremony. This year has been a difficult year for our students, and we all would have loved to be gathered together instead. However, despite it all, you have persevered, and many of our grade 12s, including our student council, yearbook committee, and bicycle club, have tried to create memories for some virtual and in-person fun. All of you deserve an applause for making it, and today we want to celebrate you, the class of 2021. As a fellow alum, I can say that you all exemplify what it means to have maroon pride. You should all be proud of what you have accomplished. As you view the ceremony from your homes, pat yourself on the back. When you see your name, cheer and look forward with no regrets. Now, to begin our ceremony, we present the DMCI grad choir singing O Canada, followed by greetings from Mayor Bowman and opening remarks from our principal, Mr. Belmore.
Today, I'd like to send a very special message to everyone at Daniel McIntyre Collegiate, and especially the graduating class of 2021. Graduation is a time to look back with pride and happiness on all you've achieved. You've been great representatives of your school, its spirit, its traditions, and its contributions to our community. You've also reached a huge personal milestone in developing the knowledge, skills, and character that will assure your future. I know high school has been different for you than for any previous generation. The world was turned upside down. You've had to cope with cancellations, disruptions, and distancing, and I know it hasn't been easy. Here's what gives me hope. You give me hope. I believe you are the most active, empathetic, engaged, and inclusive generation of Winnipeggers ever. In fact, I believe you'll one day be known as our kindest generation. Throughout the pandemic, you've been a strong support to parents, grandparents, and siblings. You've worked hard on behalf of charities, philanthropy, and the community. You've innovated brilliantly in science, technology, and the arts, and you've been amongst the strongest voices encouraging our journey of reconciliation and calling for a Winnipeg without racism. I believe the future's in good hands, and those hands are yours. Speaking to a graduating class in 1977, Maya Angelou said, "I encourage you to live with life. Be courageous, be adventurous, give us a tomorrow more than we deserve." And that's my wish for you, graduating class of 2021. Miigwech, merci, and thank you for everything you do for Winnipeg. Congratulations, and may all of your brightest dreams come true.
Good morning, class of 2021, and our guests associated with these fine young individuals. This past year has been a rare and challenging experience for everyone, not only for us as individuals, but as students, educators, family, and community members. At this time, it's nice to have this opportunity to interact with you. if only virtually. As the pandemic has kept you home in one form or another for the majority of the school year, either through alternate cohorted days or through your switch to full remote. This global challenge has forced us all to rethink how one accomplishes what still needs to be done. And those of you achieving graduation today have not let these disruptions stand in your way. Unlike the class preceding you, who had to stay home for about 3 months, you and your classmates had to endure an entire year of upheaval and change. And this fact alone has set you apart from the classes that have graduated before you. Now, it doesn't occur very often, but I do remember hearing some students say, "For the first time, I'm dying to go back to school." Fortunately, we have worked as a community to make the changes necessary to ensure that we completed this year somewhat in person, despite not knowing the challenges ahead. I'm honored to be here as a part of this significant moment for you. Graduation is an occasion of feelings. It's a mixture of delight, sadness. I apologize for you and your parents that you cannot be in a large venue to celebrate this moment as a family. I also apologize that your friends and classmates aren't here for cheering and high fives. But I believe the sense of hope and wonderment of what lies ahead for you is still the same. Class of 2021, you are ready for this moment. You are ready for the next chapter of your life. Like other high school graduates, you will enjoy the greatest scale of freedom in the next chapter of your life. You will have many decisions to make, be they personal or professional. As graduates of Daniel McIntyre, the road ahead of you will be different for you from some of your peers, for you have chosen to attend a school with a long-standing tradition of excellence in academics, athletics, performing, and visual arts. You will need this quality education that you have received to face a world that no recent graduating classes have ever faced. Our hope rests in your generation, and it appears to be in good hands. As you are the most progressive, well-educated, and open to change generation in our nation's history. Our society, our planet, and our way of life depend upon you. And I feel greatly confident that you're ready to face the challenge in our collective futures. After today, it's time to get underway. There's going to be an amazing time the next 10, 15, 20 years as we see what happens with innovative technology, with the expanding influence of community, with the return of globalization, and our duties as global citizens. However, your position in our collective future has never been more undefined, as it is exceedingly difficult to define situations and events that until this time have never had a precedent. Therefore, it is important for you to become self-sufficient in your learning. Gone are the times of predictable jobs and futures and ways of educating. For there has been a seismic shift in education towards you becoming responsible for your own learning journey. No teacher, professor, or mentor that you currently have has the ability to know exactly what our futures hold. It is up to you to remain open for all learning opportunities that occur. For it is you that must lead your own journey towards the educational standards and knowledge that will soon become the norm in your future. This is your only path forward, and you must have the ability to figure it out. We must make it better for all of us, for the generations to come, to be able not to only survive, but to thrive together. As you journey from this point forward, you will soon realize the importance of learning from all circumstance, positive or negative. And the best example of these lessons that can be associated from our pandemic. The global upheaval caused by this event gives you the opportunity to be part of the remaking of the world as it should be. To see COVID-19 as a force majeure that compels us to rewrite the social contract that has been left in shambles by nature's wrath and our own inabilities to respond to these situations. To make your mark in a new world will be difficult. It's going to take a lot of patience. It's going to take a lot of commitment, as any task worth doing does. As you strive to attain your goals, you will hear those voices. The voices that will tell you that you will not make a difference. The voices that will tell you to set your sights lower. It is easy to succumb to the lesser path, but lesser paths lead to lesser satisfaction. You are the one that establishes your goals. You are the one that will work towards them. You are the one that will ultimately achieve what it is you seek. The dedication, the commitment, the courage, and the resiliencies you've demonstrated to us over the last 13 years have led you to this point. These skills you own as graduates of Daniel McIntyre Collegiate will carry you for the rest of your life. I'd like to thank your parents for trusting us with their most valuable gift, their children, to allow us to educate, nurture, and grow them into the strong young people that you have become. We have now come to the end of our shared journey together, and from this point on, you are in charge. Now, no matter which path you've chosen for yourself at this time, be it post-secondary or career, trust in the fact that we wish you nothing but ultimate success for you as you transition from students to alumni of Daniel McIntyre Collegiate. You've joined the ranks of 97 proud alumni classes who have traveled this path before you. So as we say farewell to you as students, we welcome you as lifelong alumni of DMCI. Thank you.
Mr. Belmore, Ms. Davidson, Mr. Bendu, DMCI staff, parents, and you, graduates of 2021, good morning. For those of you who don't know me, hi, hello, my name is Bea Oriel, and it's a great honor for me to stand before all of you today. 3 years, wow. It's been three, 4 odd years since we climbed the stairs and stumbled into the front doors of Daniel Mac. As I was writing this speech, there was one word that primarily crossed my mind when I look back to what we've been through. Tumultuous. It was loud, chaotic, disorderly, like the hallways on the first day when we newbies didn't know where our lockers were or where our first subjects were. And it was like that for every single class exchange of every day. Everybody would filter out and goof around, and there would always be that group of friends who would walk so slow in front of people. The festive pep rallies and inclusive spirit weeks, which always got my voice so hoarse from yelling. The calf during the fourth period was the very definition of chaos. There was laughter and bickering, and then someone would scream or sing happy birthday. And the library. I know we all snuck food at one time. Sorry to the teachers in charge. We had numerous extracurricular activities that made each and every month so lively and fun. I still remember the anticipation that I always felt when Tuesday came, because that meant I had reached for the top and I get to spend the afternoon with my friends. The anticipation we all had felt when the Halloween dance was right around the corner and friend groups were planning matching outfits. It was always those little things that made school worthwhile. My mother tells me, whenever she reminisces about the past, that high school will always be the best time of your life. It might be true for some, may not be for others, but there is one thing that we can agree on. These past 3-4 years have molded us into the people that we are now. I believe we are like a seed that is sown into the soil, a soil so fertile of mentors, teachers, and staff who are ready to guide us as we grow year by year, who always have their doors and their hearts open to us, ready to hear our problems and anxieties, willing to help in any way that they can. Every day as a seed growing, we are watered with knowledge, not only from lessons like the Pythagorean theorem or Newton's laws or the Magna Carta, but also precious pieces of advice about life that teachers share through stories from their youth, something that we can keep in our hearts forever as we venture out of the school's brick walls and into the world. Thank you, teachers, for always having our best interests at heart. I'll miss your stories the most. There is also sunlight, bright ideas from fellow students that are shared through group discussions or casual conversations. Such opinions and ideas remind us that we are surrounded by brilliant people, all working hard towards one particular goal, graduation. And it wasn't easy, wasn't it? It was tumultuous, disruptive, confusing, emotional. We were subjected to harsh growing conditions, freezing wind in the form of homework, quizzes, labs, tests, blowing snow in the form of procrastination, school drama, project presentations, and essay papers, an unexpected and turbulent storm in the form of the pandemic. Pandemic, the very thing that darkened our senior year. There were lots of things that it took from us. Learning time, time with our friends, a normal school year. March 2020 felt like the beginning of the end, and it was suffocating to be isolated from other people. But we made it work, didn't we? The teachers and staffs were open to hear our questions and complaints, always an email away. The student council organized online activities like the Halloween contest and the Spirit Weeks. They tried so hard to make our last year memorable despite the restrictions. Our parents, a beloved constant in our life, our number one supporters, they're here with us, cheering us on. This is our time to pay back for all the sacrifices that they've given, all the extra shifts, all the headaches. You all know we're menaces. It's the least we can do. Us, we always try to stay connected through Discord, Telegram, FaceTime. We're all one call away. And for that, I thank you, each and every single one of you, for trying so hard, for hanging in there, for doing your best despite going through these tough times. There were lots of things that we failed to experience. Tournaments, winning the grade wars, the big senior prank, senior skip day, grad ball. But we were together throughout the hardships. And we made it. The time has arrived, and against all odds, the seed has now become a tree with branches stretched out and ready to face a new horizon. It's cliche, but another chapter in our lives is unfolding right before us. It's exciting to think about, I know, but it's also frightening to not know what lies ahead. However, we must take our backpack full of experiences from the last 3-4 years and carry it towards another beginning of a new journey. And as we reach the crossroads and choose our individual paths, we must pass on the torch to the next generation of Maroons and leave behind all we have learned and loved. This is our new challenge now, my fellow graduates. This is our new horizon. And as friends, together, we pursue these new dreams and passions. Together, let us soar high and dream big, bigger, and more bigger. For in this way, we can achieve greater things. Congratulations to us, graduates of 2021.
We, the president and co-vice presidents of the student body and representatives of the graduating class of Daniel McIntyre Collegiate, carry this torch as a symbol, the symbol of our knowledge. As it was placed in its shields, it became the emblem of our school, a symbol of our ideas and aspirations.
This emblem and everything that it signifies has now been placed into your care. May this torch carry your way through the future, and may this emblem inspire you through every endeavor.
We, the incoming presidents
and co-vice presidents and the representatives of the grades 9s, 10s, and 11s, accept our responsibility as Danielites.
And maintaining the tradition that was established before us.
We will strive to keep the flame aglow and to bear the emblem proudly, knowing that only the best endeavor is good enough for our school and ourselves.
Now we would like to present this year's honor roll recipients. Honor roll, to recognize those students who have achieved a minimum of 5 mark-based courses with an overall average of at least 80% with no single mark below 70%. This year's honor roll recipients are Brent Aparquez, Ezra Aiden Muhammad Ali, Christelle Aguilar, Wajid Bakht, Julia Bu, Dixie Bukhau, CJ Casas, Clyde Castillo, Jordan Diocareza, Bren Diestro, Kyle Dugillo, Jed Emeterio, Troy Garcia, Anna Gonzaga, Aliana Herrera, Huang Huynh, Tony Huynh, Caitlin Johnson, Gerard LaLuna, Jasmine Lee, Ryder Lim, Nicole Lopez, Baxter Madore, Derek Malari, Benny Martinez, Anna Mala, Bama Moroso, Mark Musni, Bin Nguyen, Paige Ortiz, Christine Robson, Lance Soriaga, Jade Tabalina, Dang Tran, Austin Velicaria, Oromia Wancha, Daylene Webster, and Erica Zamora. Honor roll with distinction. To recognize those students who achieved a minimum of 5 marks-based courses with an overall average above 90%, with no single mark below 80%. Maria Gwyneth Arsenio, Lance Bergeman, Denzel Sellis, Aliana Coloma, Isaac Dima, Marvin Diocno, Jessica Galang, Aaron Herrera, Kating Huang, Julianne Jadermeo, Kate Lacerna, Kane Lontok, Nicole Magnaye, Gwen Mercado, Billy Nguyen, Kara Omero, Bea Oriel, Kyla Pablo, Nathan Panaligan, Zan Santos, Mika Santos, Darshan Singh, Lucy Tai, Sasha Vasquez, Kelly Villamayor, Clarice Villegas, and Leon Gonkies. Honor roll achievement. To recognize those students who have achieved honor roll or honor roll with distinction for every semester from grade 10 through grade 12 at DMCI. Brent Abarquez, Julia Bu, CJ Casas, Clyde Castillo, Denzel Sellis, Aliana Coloma, Jordan Diocareza, Bren Diestro, Isaac Dima, Marvin Diocno, Jessica Galang, Aaron Herrera, Nicole Lopez, Baxter Madore, Venny Martinez, Anna Mala, Gwen Mercado, Mark Musni, Bin Nguyen, Bea Oriel, Kyla Pablo, Zan Santos, Darshan Singh, Jade Tabalina, Dang Tran, Sasha Vasquez, Kelly Villamayor, Clarice Villegas, Leanne Von Gies. Congratulations, DMCI Honor Roll recipients. And now we will present this year's award recipients. Open scholarships from Westland Foundation. Westland Foundation Education Fund, WFEF scholarships, are available to award first-year tuition fees at Red River College, the University of Manitoba, and the University of Winnipeg. Students who have completed grades 7 to 12 in any inner Winnipeg schools, including Daniel McIntyre Collegiate, are eligible to apply. For Red River, every mark over 70% qualifies for the scholarship. For University of Manitoba and University of Winnipeg, every mark over 80% qualifies. Peaceful Village Scholarships. The Peaceful Village is an after-school program for newcomer youth and families where we help the students with their homework, provide food, and conduct activities. At the end of the school year, students who have worked to support their peers and volunteer with our organization are awarded scholarships. This year's recipients are Sameya Abdullahi, Sarah Tesfaski, Amal Mohammed Noor, and Joharo Noor Mohammed. Winnipeg School Division Book Awards, presented by the Winnipeg School Division to recognize graduating students with high academic achievement. And the 12 recipients are Brent Aparquez, Jana Bautista, Adrian Kalimlim, Oji Castillo, Clyde Castillo, Marvin Diocno, Jessica Galang, Aliana Herrera, Kara Omero, Trisha Sokolis, Chow Tai, Clarice Villegas. Maroon and White Scholarship, presented by Daniel McIntyre Collegiate Institute to recognize graduating students with high academic achievement who have made an overall contribution to the school. And the recipients are Kate Lacerna, Nicole Lopez, Leanne Von Gies. Young Pinay Citizenship Award. Pinay's Manitoba Inc. is a local organization of Filipino women in Manitoba since 2016, whose mandate is to recognize, uplift, and support Filipino women in Manitoba. Young Pinay Citizenship Award is presented to two graduating students who have links to the Filipino community, identify as female, show leadership, and have proven ability to inspire and positively impact others through school, after-school activities, including sports, arts, and community service. And the recipients are Dixie Bukhao, Claynor Hernandez. Paula Levin Award, presented by Daniel McIntyre Collegiate Institute to a graduating student with the highest overall average in grade 12 science, including biology, chemistry, and physics. And the recipient is Aaron Herrera. MLA Citizenship Awards, presented by MLA Malaya Marcelino to recognize graduating students who volunteer, demonstrate good citizenship, and are positive role models in the community. And the recipients are Maria Gwyneth Arsenio, Olivier Sabaniza. Member of Parliament Canadian Studies Award, presented by Leia Gazan, Member of Parliament for Winnipeg Center, to recognize a graduating student with high academic achievement in Canadian Studies, including history and geography. And the recipient is Gwen Mercado. A message from Leia Gazan. I want to share my congratulations with the 2021 graduating class of DMCI. I have had the pleasure of meeting some of you, and your brilliance, creativity, and commitment to our community is clear. I can't wait to see what you do next. I also want to extend my deepest admiration and respect for all students and staff who have continued to learn and create a space for learning in the middle of such a difficult time. Sincerely, Leia Gazan, Member of Parliament, Winnipeg Center. Manitoba Credit Union Scholar Athlete Award. The Manitoba High Schools Athletic Association, with support from Manitoba's credit unions, is pleased to announce the 2020-2021 Manitoba's Credit Union Scholar Athlete Awards. In this COVID-19 pandemic year, recognizing the extenuating hardships students have had to overcome and in their continued support of student athletes across our province, this year, Manitoba's credit unions recognize student athletes from across the province. And the recipient is Aaron Herrera. Suche Gossin Foundation Scholarship, presented by the Suche Gossin Foundation to recognize a graduating student who is committed to education and is involved in the school and the greater community, and who has financial need. And the recipient is Bea Oriel. Welcome Hand Scholarship, presented by the Suche Gossin Foundation to recognize a graduating student not born in Canada, who is committed to education and is involved in the school and the greater community, and who has financial need. And the recipient is Gadir Al-Najjar. Red River College Partners in Education Scholarship, presented by Red River College and Daniel McIntyre Collegiate Institute to recognize a graduating student with reasonable academic standing who is accepted into a program at RRC. And the recipient is Corinne Edayan. Winnipeg Teachers Association Scholarship, presented by the Winnipeg Teachers Association to a graduating student who has exhibited outstanding citizenship and is enrolled in post-secondary education. And the recipient is Claynor Hernandez. Chan Centennial Scholarship, presented by the University of Manitoba to a graduating student with an overall average over 85% and is attending post-secondary education at the University of Manitoba. And the recipient is Jessica Galam. Graduating Athlete Award of Distinction, presented by the DMCI Physical Education Department to graduating athletes who have demonstrated outstanding contributions to DMCI athletics over their 3 years at DMCI and have had a positive influence on the culture and community of the school. Students must have strong athletic achievement while demonstrating great leadership on and off the court. They must have participated in a minimum of 2 sports in each of grade 10 and 11 and 1 sport in grade 12. And the recipients are Dixie Bukhau, Damian Hemans, Aaron Herrera, Baxter Madori, Gabriel Sa, and Erica Zamora. Sherman Himmelblau Memorial Award, presented by Daniel McIntyre Collegiate Institute to a graduating student who is involved in music and drama and exhibits strong leadership skills. And the recipient is Chan Nguyen. Edward Isao Matani Memorial Bursary Fund, presented to a graduating student who demonstrates commitment to their education through participation in athletics and extracurricular activities. And the recipient is Aaron Herrera. The Matani family lived in Winnipeg's West End, and all 3 children, Florence the eldest, Edward and Brian, graduated from Daniel McIntyre Collegiate Institute back in the 1950s and 1960s. This bursary is in memory of Edward, who recently passed away, and the important role played by and the memories he had of Daniel Mac. Edward was especially talented as he was part of the Daniel Mac Maroons football team and also sang in a Daniel concert, HMS Pinafore. Edward also excelled in hockey and tennis as he played playground and midget level hockey for the Orioles Community Club. Edward was always very thankful for his experiences at Daniel Mac. Edward passed away in February 2019, and in his memory, the Matani family established this bursary to recognize the school and community of which Edward and the family had such great memories. We therefore hope this bursary will assist this year's Daniel McIntyre graduate, Aaron, to achieve his goals and future aspirations. William J.S. Brown Scholarship, presented by Daniel McIntyre Collegiate Institute to a graduating student with good academic standing who is pursuing further studies in music. And the recipient is Miley Pov. Joe Uggams Award, presented by alumnus Joe Uggams to 2 graduating students with high academic standing who participated in interscholastic athletics and are attending post-secondary education. And the recipients are Dixie Bukhau and Gabriel Sa. Emergent Biosolutions Award, presented by Emergent Biosolution to a graduating student who is a Canadian citizen, maintains high academic standing in science, demonstrates outstanding commitment to their local community, and is attending post-secondary education. And the recipient is Kara Omero. Johan General Award, presented by alumnus Johan General to a graduating student who is pursuing post-secondary education in the area of arts or graphic arts. And the recipient is Lance Bergeman. Alumni Merit Awards, presented by the DMCI Alumni Association to graduating students with high academic achievement in each of the different subject areas. And the recipients are, for Social Studies, Claynor Hernandez. For Mathematics, Chow Tai. For English Language Arts, Leanne Von Gies. For Music, Mark Musney. for Business Education, Lance Bergeman. For Art, Julianne Odulio. For Physical Education and Health, Aaron Herrera. For Science, Leanne Von Gies. For Human Ecology, Maria Fabros. For Industrial Arts, Finley De La Reina. For English as an Additional Language, Sarah Tesfazgi. For Dance, Anthony Jed Emeterio. Alumni 75th Anniversary Scholarship, presented by the DMCI Alumni Association to a graduating student who has made a unique contribution to the school and is attending post-secondary education. And the recipient is Baxter Madore. Woman of Distinction Award, presented by DMCI Alumni Class of 1968 to 1971 to a female graduating student who embodies the principles of Daniel McIntyre Collegiate and is attending post-secondary education. And the recipient is Heather Horbis. Daniel McIntyre Alumni Scholarship, presented by the DMCI Alumni Association to a graduating student with reasonable academic standing who is attending post-secondary education. And the recipient is Heather Horbis. Daniel McIntyre Technical Vocational Scholarship, presented by David Rich and Jareth Gronsky to a graduating student with good academic standing who is attending technical vocational post-secondary education. And the recipient is Sarah Tesfazgi. Henry and Doreen Bennigan Scholarship, presented by the Winnipeg Foundation to a graduating student with high academic standing and proficiency in mathematics and community involvement who is attending post-secondary education. And the recipient is Aaron Herrera. William Majid Mahar Bursary, presented by the Winnipeg Foundation to a graduating student of Indigenous ancestry who is attending post-secondary education. And the recipient is Alabama Moroso. DMCI Centennial Scholarship, presented by the Winnipeg Foundation to a graduating student with high academic standing who has made an overall contribution to the school and is attending post-secondary education. And the recipient is Kane Lontoc. Jack Johnson Memorial Football Scholarship, presented by the Johnson family to a graduating student who has made a contribution to the DMCI football program, exhibited good sportsmanship and recognized self-development, and is attending post-secondary education. And the recipient is Baxter Madore. George Taylor Spirit of Leadership Award, presented by McClure Place Incorporated to a graduating student with academic excellence who demonstrates leadership in the school and community and is attending post-secondary education. And the recipient is Bea Oriel. This year's George Taylor Spirit of Leadership Award is presented to Bea Oriel. Bea has put significant effort into her academic achievement, including taking high-end mathematics and sciences courses. She has focused on enriched level pre-calculus mathematics and has taken advanced placement biology. Additionally, Bea was one of the students who participated in the Advanced Placement Capstone Program, a two-year, two-credit program that, rather than teaching subject-specific content, focuses on developing student skills in research, making academic arguments, writing and presenting, among other skills essential for success in post-secondary education. With all Ms. Oriel has accomplished at Daniel McIntyre, McClure Place is proud to offer this scholarship to help her with her future. We feel she is a future leader, and we are proud to help her out with this goal. Tri-Scholars Scholarship, presented by Tau Gamma Phi to a graduating student who has arrived in Canada from the Philippines within the last 2 years and is attending post-secondary education. Tau Gamma Phi, also known as Triskelion's Grand Fraternity, was established in 1968 at the University of the Philippines, the premier institution of higher learning in the country. Since its establishment, the organization and its counterpart sorority, Tau Gamma Sigma, have distinguished themselves in campus politics and social development work. Alumni organizations have also been established in many countries. In 2008, alumni chapters from major cities in Canada formed to create the Canada National Council. Today, there are 15 regional councils found in various provinces all over Canada. 8 years ago, in partnership with Daniel McIntyre Collegiate Institute, Tau Gamma Phi started offering the Tri-Scholar Award to a deserving graduate student with full or partial Filipino parentage. Today, Tau Gamma Phi remains committed to supporting students that embody the criteria required of a Tri-Scholar. Finally, I would like to congratulate the class of 2021, and with great pleasure and honor, I present this year's Tri-Scholar Award to Maria Michaela Santos. CGC Award of Merit, presented by the Winnipeg School Division Clinical Support Services to a graduating student who has overcome personal hardships in order to successfully complete high school. The CGC Award of Merit was established in 2011 in commemoration of 60 years of service to children and families in the community. Awards of Merit are presented to graduating high school students in the Winnipeg School Division who have shown resilience and determination in the face of adversity. This year's recipient came to Canada with her mother and three siblings from Chile when she was 11 in winter 2014 to join her father who had arrived a few years earlier. She worked hard and went to summer school to learn English while helping her parents take care of her siblings, one of whom has special needs. She helped maintain the family home, all while working diligently at school. She maintained passing marks and was able to participate in extracurricular activities like DMCI's Finest, in which she excelled. And the recipient is Omira Plaza Urea. John Lawler Memorial Scholarship, presented by the Lawler family to a graduating student who has completed the English as an additional language program and is attending post-secondary education. And the recipient is Kating Huang. Douglas Todd Memorial Award, presented by the Todd family to a graduating student with high academic standing with an interest in flying or engineering and is attending post-secondary education. And the recipient is Austin Velicaria. The Douglas Todd Memorial Award was established 27 years ago in 1994 through the generosity of Mrs. Jessie Todd, a resident of Home Street, in honor of her only son, Douglas. Congratulations, Austin, on receiving this award. Good luck in all your future studies. Beverly Wong Memorial Scholarship, presented by the Wong family to a graduating student with good academic standing, good citizenship, and an interest in early childhood education. And the recipient is Roselle German. John Hatcher Award, presented by Daniel McIntyre Collegiate Institute to a graduating student with good academic standing who has made an overall contribution to the school. And the recipient is Brent Abarquez. Takahiro Yamashita Memorial Bursary, presented by Daniel McIntyre Collegiate Institute to a graduating student with good academic standing who has shown strong school participation. And the recipient is Kyla Pablo. DMCI Awards, presented by Daniel McIntyre Collegiate Institute to two graduating students with high academic achievement. And the recipients are Paige Ortiz and Jem Janelle Santos. DMCI Maroon Awards, presented by Daniel McIntyre Collegiate Institute to two graduating students with high academic achievement. And the recipients are Julia Boo and Julianne Jettermeo. Walter and Maria Schroeder Scholarships, Red River College. Presented by the Walter and Maria Schroeder Foundation this year to 14 graduating students with high academic achievement who are attending post-secondary education at Red River College. And the recipients are Alfred Cadavedo, Aircraft Maintenance. Jordan Diocareza, Refrigeration and Air Conditioning. Hamza Farah, Business Administration. Jethro Garcia, Electrical. Zurich Guantz, Mechanical Engineering Technology. Huang Quinn, Automotive Technician Diploma. Audrey Legaspi, Business Information Technology. Derek Malari, Structural Engineering Technology. Jean Malari, Medical Device Reprocessing Technology. Angelo Marshall, Business Information Technology. Anna Mala, Administrative Assistant. Janine Soriano, Business Administration. Dang Tran, Business Administration. Walter and Maria Schroeder Scholarships, University of Manitoba. Presented by the Walter and Maria Schroeder Foundation to aid graduating students with high academic achievement who are attending post-secondary education at the University of Manitoba. And the recipients are Eliana Coloma, Asper School of Business. Denise Delapaz, Asper School of Business. Isaac Dima, University One, Architecture. Vinny Martinez, Engineering. Darshan Singh, Science. Jade Tabalina, University One, Asper School of Business. Sasha Vasquez, Engineering. Kelly Villamayor, Science. Winnipeg School Board Scholarship. Presented by the Winnipeg School Division to a graduating student with high academic achievement who is attending post-secondary education. And the recipient is Aaron Herrera. Governor General's Medal, presented by the Governor General of Canada to the graduating student with the highest overall grades 11 and 12 average in the class. And the recipient is Aaron Herrera. McIntyre Medal, presented by Donna McIntyre Collegiate Institute to a graduating student with high academic achievement and outstanding citizenship. And the recipient is Benny Martinez. Congratulations to this year's awards winners. Best of luck in your future.
Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the class of 2021, we would like to welcome all special guests, families, friends, teachers, staff, Mr. Belmore, Ms. Davidson, Mr. Bendu, and most importantly, the graduating class of 2021. So hey, if you don't know me, my name is Dixie Bukau, and before I start, I would like to thank everyone who is watching this morning and for giving me the honor to talk to the class of 2021. Man, where do I even begin? Where do I even start? Time has never been so quick to rush us out into the big world, but here we are. After today, we will be heading our separate ways and starting a brand new chapter in our lives, but not in the way we expected it to end. The class of 2021 really had a different experience this year. Most of us arrived here at DMCI during our sophomore year and spent half of our high school experience at home. We only got to spend one full year with each other, and that was it. This was really unfortunate. We had hope for our senior year to be as normal as possible, but it wasn't to be that way. But we accepted the fate of how this year was going to go, and we used that to our advantage to make it the best we could under the circumstances. So our senior year wasn't what we had hoped for, but all we could do was move on and continue. As we spent our senior year at home, it turned out to be a blessing in disguise. We all grew as individuals. We learned and spent more time on ourselves. We got our first jobs, passed our road tests. We found a sense of style. We grew new skills and habits. And most importantly, we persevered through the hardships. This year may have been difficult, but we managed to have some laughs along the way. We made it work and we became stronger in the end. In life, you have to keep moving forward and capture the positive aspects and remember them forever. For example, remember when we took our grad pics? We headed down to the cafe, we took a left, and once we entered, a whole bunch of memories started flashing into our minds. Our heads turning left and right, reminiscing on the memories we had over the years. The cafeteria seemed like the only class that everyone looked forward to and excelled at, where everyone was screaming from playing a simple card game or to an intense Smash game with your friends, or buying bagels, bobs, poutines, and guessing if the cookies were soft or not, or even joining in when someone was singing happy birthday. Because that's the type of environment DMCI is. Remember when we got to dunk Mr. Shane and Mr. Chachanov in the dunk tank? Or our very own Louise Gerarna won the donut eating contest last year? Also, don't forget about the loss of the JV Boys City Championship trophy that stayed at DMCI for 12 years. Way to go, guys. But there are some things we can say goodbye to. Like waking up early in the morning just to go to school. Tests and assignments all due on the same day because we all know teachers plan that to happen. Being scared of physics because it could potentially ruin your average and honor roll. Or putting so much effort into a math question just to end up being completely wrong. But in all seriousness, we would like to thank the teachers here at DMCI. They continued and adjusted their teaching methods to fit our needs, which makes them amazing teachers. They supported us through this pandemic and made sure we kept up with our academics. You are truly heroes in disguise, and we can't thank you enough. I would also like to take this time to thank my parents and siblings at home for their endless support in both my athletics and academics. As cliche as this sounds, without them, I wouldn't be the person I am today. So thank you guys. And thank you to all the parents and families who have supported us every day. But now that we are saying goodbye, it's getting harder to leave. And that's okay. I know we didn't get what every alumni got for their senior year, but we all made it. We made memories and friendships that will hopefully last a lifetime. We grew up in this safe place that we call DMCI, our home away from home, and now it's time to leave. I know we will all go out and do great things in the world. We are a bunch of outgoing and amazing teenagers following our dreams and aspirations in life. And I would like to advise all of you to never settle and keep trying to elevate yourself to the fullest potential. Please don't take life for granted and live life to the fullest. Do the things that make you happy and follow through. To my friends, my second family, my classmates, congratulations to the class of 2021. We did it, guys.
And now we will have the presentation of the diplomas.
Kerwin Abega. Brend Abarquez. Jasmine Abdisalam. Sumaya Abdullahi. Chris Abueg. Akshay Adar. Philip Advincula. Crystal Aguilar. Prince Esporna.
Paul Alba. Salwa Ali. Aiden El Mario. Gadir Al Najar. Maria Gwyneth Arsenio. Rafael Atienza. Wahid Baksh. Theo Baldo. Joris Balasakin, Brianna Ballantyne,
Ileana Barbone, Darren Barcelo, Paul Berrios, Arthur Bautista, Jana Bautista, Lance Bergerman, Robin Burnell, Kenneth Bisek, Bono Binankal, Julia Boo,
Rana Brimo, Bea Bratanel, Annika Buchert, Dixie Bukau, Tuan Luke Bowie, Daniel Kabahug, Marielle Kabate, Gabriel Cabrera, Alfred Cadavedo, Adrian Kalimlim,
JB Canlis, Bea Cantalejo, Christian Curran, Cecile Joy Casas, Clyde Castillo, Oji Castillo, Jairi Castronuevo, Denzel Silas, Jane Bell Sinedoza, Bao Gok Chu,
Aliana Coloma, Kian Conception, Paul Concha, Raymond Coronel, Jacob Cotton, Shelby Cram, Mirella Crusetti Friedenberg, Gwen Diug, Denise De La Paz, Rafael De La Paz,
Venley De La Reina, Alizea Deluz, Jordan Diocreza, Jamila Da Rab, Daphne Diaz, Bren Diestro, Isaac Dima, Marvin Diocno, T. A. Van Doe, Ashley Kyle Dugilo,
Nathan Domingo, Jamar Duat, Anthony Emeterio, John Encarnacion, Maria Fabros, Aliyah Fakuri, Marielle Fajardo, Hamza Farah, Aliana Figueroa, Christian Flett,
Joanna Floriendo, Mark Francisco, Harley Fraser, June Futami, Jessica Galang, Jethro Garcia, Christine Gauthier, Rochelle George, Roselle German,
Anna Gonzaga, Matthew Googe, Zerg Guance, Francis Gutierrez, Salim Halimolakot, Damian Hemans, Grace Hermosa, Angela Hernandez, Claynor Hernandez,
Eliana Herrera, Aaron Herrera, Abdiaziz Hir Hussein, Heather Horbus, Kating Huang, Mansoor Hussein, Nemo Hussein, Na Phuang Huyen, Pham Pat Tien Huyen, Corrine Idayan,
Hajati Issa, Julianne Jadormeo, Caitlin Johnston, Marcus Jordan, Adrian Warana, Ethan Costa, Kara Kohut,
Kate Lacerna, Gerard LaLuna, Anne Tu Lee, T. Gok Hugh Lee, Audrey Legaspi, Ryder Lim, Lance Legas, Kane Lontok, Nicole Lopez,
Samuel Lafuta, Baxter Mador, Edrak Maglake, Nicole Magnaye, Alhadi Mahamat, Derek Malari, Jean Malari, Jerswin Manuel, Frankie Mapuyan,
Angelo Marcial, Mary Jane Marquez, Venny Martinez, Anna Maula, Christopher McAllister, Ryan McConkey, Gabrielle McDermott, Gwen Mercado, Julia Millar,
Niu Mirandilia, Rueda Mohammed, Amal Mohammed Noor, Kevin Morales, Jadzi Morrison, Bama Morisseau, Gertrude Mukunda, Christian Muleka, Mark Musni, Rico Nakabepu,
Levi's Diakiza, Thomas Noonham, Bin Tan Nguyen, Chan Nguyen, Hugh Nguyen, Lee Tuong V. Nguyen, Tai Kim Mi Nguyen, Tien Dat Nguyen,
Joharo Noor Mohammed, Gibby Obenza, Angelo Ochoa, Julian Odulio, Charles Oliveras, Kara Omero, Bea Oriel, Paige Ortiz, Najma Osman, Kyla Pablo,
Nathan Penaligan, Dominic Pelche, Felicia Perez Ginter, Socrates Pialago, Omira Plaza Urea, Miley Pav, Kirby Pruden, Rainer Ramirez, Labib Rana, Abigail Reyes, Jizkel Ringor,
Christine Robson,
Jamika Rossetti, Trinity Ross, Gabriel Sa, Jaden Sainawa, Afra Saleh, William Samuel, Zan Santos, Mika Santos, Haley Saunders,
Vijay Sibaniza, Fabrice Sibaniza, Olivier Sibaniza,
Kayla Seng,
Trisha Sokoles, Abdullah Shahab, Darshan Singh, Johan Sai, Lance Soriaga, Janine Soriano, Jade Tabellina,
Francesca Takan, Tatiana Teixeira, Angela Templo, Tenderly Tenderly, Sarah Tesfazgi, Chow Hong Tai, Christian Timbal, Liana Tined, Mickey Toledo, Dang Huang Tran,
Han Tran, Tri Hao Trung, Sasha Vasquez, Austin Villacaria, Kelly Villamayor, Clarice Villegas, Leanne Von Gies, Daylene Webster, Lynx White, Jolinda Wood, Aaliyah Yabut, Erica Zamora, Zongji Zeng.
For our graduates. And now we stand at the end of our shared journey and the beginning of a journey that will take you through the rest of your life. The horizon of your future is expanding before you, and you have chosen to be equipped with the best information and strategies to ensure that this life is filled with many more successes. Remember Daniel McIntyre Collegiate fondly, as we surely will remember you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct honor to introduce to you the graduating class of Daniel McIntyre Collegiate 2021. Thank you.